right, welcome to the Red Cup Album, man. We got my man JT in the house tonight. Charlie Moe, Charles Harrison. Two former Georgetown guys. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Two former Georgetown guys that transferred from Georgetown to another school. You know what I'm saying? So we got a lot to talk about that tonight. And not only that, we'll start off with the NCAA tournament. Watch a good game right now, Oregon, North Carolina. Boy, some man, JT, man, that team y'all had at G-Town that year, man. John Turner, Tombo, Charles Smith, that mob was nice. And y'all went down to Duke, I want to send a Super 8, I want to say. Watching these games right now, man, who you, do you think any of this team could have got with that mob y'all had, man, back in that, was it 89?
89.
Yeah, with
88, 89.
Yeah, in them teams right you watching right now with a gap with that mob, y'all had a monster mob.
Yeah. I don't think so, man. We should have won it all. You know, we went 33-3 that year, 33-4, something like that. We should have won everything, man. Duke snuck it. They got us. And, you know, that was it. But we had a hell of a mob. Yeah.
What you mean they snuck it? Man, that white boy put that motherfucker on his old ass, man. Come on, man. They don't say that, man. They snuck it. It was a good game.
It's a good game.
You know what I'm saying? I think y'all mob was one of the best teams Georgetown ever had. One of the best. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You know, outside the Pat Youngs with the Michael Grahams and the Reggie Williams. Y'all mob was right there. You know what I'm saying? You know, you had the Bay Bay Dorns with this Craig Shelton number. Y'all had a hell of a mob like that. Yeah, man. It was like, man, like you, Zoe, Matombo, that front line, man. Your job probably was a little easier than normal, but you know what I'm saying? Just playing with them 2 7-foot guys, man. Who was more like helpful to your game as far as like what you wanted to do when you got a 7 footer and 7 footer, Matombo Alonzo, as far as like, you know what I'm saying? Who you enjoy playing the court with?
Actually, I like playing with both of them. You know, Matombo was just getting over here from Africa and stuff. So, you know, and everybody, me and Zoe was real, real tight. That was my man. Y'all gonna work out, buddy. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. We just lift every day hard.
Right.
So both of them, it was good working with both of them. Lonzo and Matombo was my roommate, so that's what it was. You know what I mean?
Don't duck the question. Hey,
ain't
see,
nothing
you
the
got
question.
Lonzo or Matombo?
Lonzo, my man. Lonzo, it was Lonzo.
Okay, I mean, that's all you had to say. We don't duck no wreck, man.
No. I like the wreck.
You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, no boy, that was a great mob, though, but you know what I'm saying? But that was a hell of an era back then, too, as far as the physical play of the game, you know, and all that. What you think about now today, like the college basketball game today versus y'all playing? Do you think it's more physical back then or now?
I think it's more physical back then because, you know, they let you do a little bit more bumping. You know, they don't let you bump as much as they did back then, you know
right,
what I'm saying?
Right,
so,
right.
You know, that's how I look at it. But there's still some good players out there, man, doing their thing, you know? Yeah. What you think, y'all?
Man, I know I'm watching y'all mob with Smitty, you, man, going against St. John's at the Cap Center.
Oh, yeah.
And we saw you had the beef with Jason Williams.
Yeah.
Tell us a little about that, man, because that was carrying it on for a while, man.
Well,
had a nice rivalry going and everything.
Well, Big J was always, I like the competition when it's some big guys playing hard, you know what I mean? So, Big J was a big guy, strong guy. I know he had a big name out there, so you know. So I love just going real hard when it's somebody that I already know been playing before I even got there. You know what I mean?
Right.
So that's all.
Right. Yeah. And for the younger people out here, just give us a little background of where you started at playing and when you realized that you know. Yeah. You had a chance to make some money out of this and go to school for free. When did you start realizing that as a player?
Well, to be honest with you, man, when I first came out of high school and got a chance to go to college, it was a big thing for me, man, and a big thing for my family because I was the first one to go to college and made a career out of it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it helped me and helped my family out a lot.
Yeah. So you was at Eleanor Roosevelt.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Cap Classic.
Yes, sir.
All right. Then went Allegheny.
Yes, sir.
Okay. How was that experience out there?
Allegheny was a great, great experience, man. You know, that JUCO year was real good with Coach Kirk. He helped me get through a lot of stuff that I was going through, mm-hmm. and helped me for the next phase of my career.
Okay.
Yep.
All right. Then seeing you up Georgetown, that's big, you know, going there.
Yeah.
That's big, man.
Well, you know, you was there too, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. What was the toughest players you played against in the Big East?
Dirk Coleman was real tough. That was one of the toughest guys I played against was Dirk. Mm-hmm. Billy Owens was a bad boy. You ain't messing with Billy Owens, man, because he could use both hands real good. Yeah, nah, you know what I'm saying? He was tough.
I
think Billy was probably my toughest person I played against.
Speaking of Billy Owens, though.
Yeah.
You going with Billy Owens or Anthony Tucker? Just a question, JT. I think a lot of people.
I mean, Tucker, my man, but I got to go with Billy Owens.
Well, this my man shit. Yeah, that's my man. Ain't about that, man. You know, motherfucker fucked up with it. He fucked up with it.
I ain't
you know
fucked up with it. Tucker's boogie.
Oh, no question.
You know what I'm saying? So
no fucking question.
He can boogie. Mm-hmm. Tucker can get it. Tucker can definitely do it.
So back in high school, in them years y'all was booking, you know, you came out 86, but you seen like the 87 crew too,
yeah.
As far as the AAU mob y'all had, you know what I'm saying? Just in high school only, right? You got Amy Tucker, you got Dennis Scott.
Mm-hmm, that's my man.
And then Uriah. Just them, because you know, them both of them was the, back then.
Right.
They was like, you know, the shit back then as far exactly. as like high school basketball. So going to war in a heated game. A heated game, man. You want that Amy Tucker or you want that Dennis Scott as far as to go along with a John Turner.
Two different players.
But two different players is that's what I'm saying. So as far as you the way you play.
Two different players, though. You got.
Man, who are you?
You talking about a three and a four? You talking about a three and a four?
No, we talking about basketball. We ain't talking about three and four.
Yeah, now you talking about two different positions.
We talking about basketball.
You talking about a three and a four?
Okay, so what I'm saying, Chuck a 3-4, Dennis 3-4. I mean, so
Dennis was never four.
So
Dennis was never four.
So
AAU and me when we played,
but you can move to the five though. See what I'm saying? So by you can move to the five. Who would you want on your team? Who would you want on your team?
I'm gonna go with my man Tuck.
Okay.
I'm gonna go with Tuck.
Wait, it took you long to answer that question. I had to break the whole question down.
You gotta break it all down. You gotta be more specific, but you know.
No, JT.
You know what I'm saying?
No. That's like
it's no disrespect what I heard.
That's what it is.
Okay.
And that's why you don't have to be specific.
Okay.
That's what makes it so much, okay. You know, no disrespect.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Yeah, so
absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? But this my homie right here, man. This motherfucker JT. Man, I back when motherfucking 1986, y'all had a nice AU mob playing Mr. Kitchens.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You Mike Sumner, I think played with y'all.
Steve.
Dennis Scott.
Steve.
Y'all had a mob. And I remember y'all when it was Sunny Hill, man.
Yeah.
And played against that Brian Shorter. They called him, what they called, the Messiah.
Yeah, Brian was tough.
Man, they came back. Mr. Tough. Kitchens was like, man, they talking about Messiah.
Yeah, that boy's tough.
He said, man, we got another nigga on our motherfucking team. It's John Turner.
Absolutely.
They said, you killed that nigga up that joint.
Oh, and killed him in college, too.
Yeah.
But, you know what I'm saying? You know, I mean, we had a great, great, great squad, man. Actually, I played with another team first,
mm-hmm.
and Dennis Scott and picked me up. You know what I'm saying? AAU, how you could, you know, mm-hmm. if you lose, you can pick up two other players.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And that's how, you know what I'm saying? That's how that happened. You know what I mean?
Wow.
Yeah, man. Right. Yes, sir. You know, glad to be out here with y'all fellas, man. Y'all looking good. Y'all doing good, man. You know, I wish one of y'all let me hold $5.
Man. Damn, JT, JT, I think I owe you a lot of $5. Right? You know what I'm saying? And one thing about back here, man, this man, like, when I was younger, you know what I'm saying, anyone with a college and everything, this man called me out the blue, man, with a nice offer, man. And I look back on it, you know what I'm saying, down the day, you know what I'm saying, it, but it's still pushing it in a sense that when guys putting your name out there, wherever they at doing good, it just goes, it shows you a lot how much a guy really, really fuck with you as far as like wanting you to do good also, you know what I'm saying? And I know a lot of things you did that's good for other people, you know what I'm saying, going overseas. You got a lot of guys' jobs over there. Yeah. I mean, just off your word and all that, you know what I'm saying? So, by saying that, you know what I'm saying, like the sprints you had coming out of Georgetown, then had to make that transition to Enid, mm-hmm. which he flew me in and tried to get me in a better situation also. A lot of people don't know that with Mark Price's father. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And to get your success when people thought that it was all over for you, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh, man, he this, he doing that, going to get that, to come back and have success with it. You know what I'm saying? Like, where you at with your aspect that you put on the game itself and had people work hard? Because that wasn't work hard for what you did.
Right,
you know what I'm saying? People had you out. Oh, man, he don't want... And then...
Yeah.
Oklahoma, to me, that Oklahoma City, I think that did... I mean, Phoenix, Oklahoma, but Mark Price, probably. I think that was your turnaround and your whole aspect of the game, champ. Because I'm only saying it because I was there with you for a short period of time.
Yeah,
and right. I seen the love you was getting down there, and I seen your determination that you wanted to get where you needed to be.
Right.
So me personally, I wouldn't say the Ali Gaynor or Georgetown. I think that Enid joint was that put you in your mindset.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because I mean, you was away from home, around good people, and all you had to do was get your John Turner shit together as far as like just wanting to get in that motherfucking league.
Well, that was the whole thing, man. The whole thing was to get away from the area. So when I got away from the area, I got back more focused. Georgetown was good for me. I liked it. You know, you're at home, you got everybody around you. But when I got out there, wasn't around it, but besides some, you know, we got to look at some cows and stuff like that, man. It wasn't nothing really doing Oklahoma, man. You know what I'm saying? So I couldn't party, you know what I mean? So I had to stay focused. And anybody know me, man, I love being in the gym. So by me staying in the gym all the time, that got me more balanced of just focusing on playing basketball, you know what I'm saying? So, and I went out there, man, and like I say, Mark Price called me and said, man, look, my father's a good coach, you need to go out there, and I went out there, and Mr. Price just said, if you do what I tell you to do, you're going to go to the next level, and that's what happened, uh-huh. You know? So, had a great 2 years out there, and the rest was history, you know? Uh-huh.
Yeah, no, that's exactly what happened. You went up there, joined the deal you had to do. Who's it? Well, you had Darryl McClain was out there with you, right?
Darryl McClain, and I had a point guard too, my man.
JT. If a power forward can't remember their point guard name,
that's what man.
That mean that motherfucker wasn't that good. Yeah, what though? You saying he wasn't that good?
Or
you
old man's name out, man.
Okay, then that's crazy, man.
Yeah.
And so, what was your draft process like? You realize you had some time.
I'm gonna tell you what I was kind of fucked up about was when they brought me down to Portsmouth, and they had people starting in front of me. I was kind of pissed off. You know what I'm saying? So, my man Steve Hood was starting in front of me, and all these guys were starting out in front of me. And I walked out there with MVP. I came off the bench and still walked out of Portsmouth for MVP. The dude, Marty Blake, told me, is Marty still head of the... He ain't probably doing it no more. He was
the head of the draft. He was the man back then.
He was the man back then. He wanted to tell everybody. So then we went down to Lando. And went down to Lando, then they figured out who the fuck John Turner was. And
I was there.
Yeah, exactly. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's when they said, we're going to put this dude ain't been a starting line.
Yeah, I was actually there.
Exactly. And Red Auerbach came to me, had a cigar and stuff, told me, son, I don't think you're going to be there when we draft, but if you are, we're going to take you. And Boston that year had the 24th pick, and it took Rick Fox, but I went 20. So
you went before? Okay, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so that was big for me, man.
That's some huge shit, man, back in that early to be in the goddamn top 20.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The draft, you know what I'm saying? Just come from hard work, you know what I'm saying? That's some hell of a shit right there, you know what I'm saying?
But I got something to say too. I was kind of hurt, man. You know, I set some up for my boy Kirk, man, and you know, Italy, they love me, and they said, man, who I need a point. You need a point guard. Who can you bring over here? First person came to my mind was Kirk. So I'm calling around to get his number because I lost his number. Get Kirk's number, call him. Say, Kirk, I got some good money on the table for you.
I know exactly. I discussed that.
I got some good money on the table for you, man. Mm-hmm. You only got to do number 5 months. Some good money. I don't want to tell people the money you turned down, but some good money on the table. I had the people, man, get my man a first-class ticket. So we in practice, waiting to pick my boy. They get me out of practice, say, man, your man ain't show up at the airport. So I'm calling your mom and calling everybody, where Kirk at? I thought maybe you was in a car accident or something. I ain't know what happened because you didn't make it. You know what I'm saying? So, you know. But I also had off on the table for Lonnie Herrera. And Lonnie just told me he wanted to trial guest New Jersey Nets. You know what I'm saying? That was the time. You know what I'm saying?
I remember that.
You know, so it's a couple of people, man, I had offers out there for, man, because they, when you're in a country so long, they know what you could do. They take your word for
exactly.
You know
what I'm saying? That's why I said people don't know what, how many opportunities you put people in to succeed the same way you did get the experience. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
That's why it's all about, you know what I'm saying, just being hungry about that shit. And doing what you got to do to get, and you know, on that level. And what you did and tried to do for people, a lot of these guys now today don't even fucking think about that shit. Right. Guys is in positions now to look out for somebody, to say, man, hey, showcase your talent here and there. These guys got pool that does it, man. We got a lot of local guys in the league that so goddamn good, man, that to me personally, don't get other guys a chance.
Right.
What you did back then, when that motherfucking competition level was all of it, you was giving guys like myself opportunities, man, come and get some of this money, Joe.
Right, it's too much.
You know what I'm saying? Come and get some of this money. Yeah. Get the fuck away from home.
Yeah.
You know, and all that. You know what I'm saying? And you know, some guys take the right way, some take the wrong way.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But then you think back on it, you got, oh man, I should have did the shit of that. You know what I'm saying?
But
to live and talk about the situation, hopefully guys are listening, man, that do that same shit that JT did try to do for guys, man, back in the day. Yeah. Well, people don't even know stories as far as what this man has actually, you know what I'm saying, done for me as far as like been inspiration in my life. You know what I'm saying? I'm in Compton Community College. You know what I'm saying? You know, JT out there with the Rockets. You know, I look up, boom, Houston, boom, boom. I call, make one call, you know what I'm saying? JT got my shit right there, tickets, go to the hotel room, chill out. Remember, boy, I'm sure my boy from Compton, I got my boy in the NBA. So that, on the way home, the whole way home, this man, he can't believe it. He ain't never been to the goddamn Staples, the Forum, whatever they call it, back then the Forum. So I'm way from D.C., my man live in L.A. You mean to tell me you ain't never been in the goddamn Forum until I got here? You know what I'm saying? To see a good buddy of mine playing the NBA. You know what I'm saying? Like, the whole way home, he was so thankful. Like, damn. Like, all my life, man, I ain't never seen no shit like that. You know what I'm saying? But to me, it was just a homie that I knew worked hard to get where he at. And looking out for me like he always do. And I just happened to be in the right town at the time to get to see a real good friend of mine in a goddamn NBA uniform. You know what I'm saying? Because, man, this nigga been talking about a lot of people, man, years before reaching that level. Years before reaching that level, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't understand that part of it. You know what I'm saying? Like, coming from some bullshit to just making some shit happen. I mean, I done seen him do that. You know what I'm saying? So, it's been days when we ain't have shit in our pocket.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, no car to drive.
Preach.
Like, all that shit. Like, it's real talk. We just like JT and Kirk Smith just can hoop, but fuck them niggas.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Had to walk to the corner.
Walk to the corner, get some sandwiches and shit.
Yeah.
Couldn't get nobody a car. You know what I'm saying? Like that. You know what I'm saying? But when this motherfucker, this is funny shit, though. When this motherfucker bought his first motherfucking car, he come up Georgetown, boom, and just pull that motherfucker in the parking lot and say, shorty, remember we couldn't, you know what I'm saying, we couldn't even get a ride to go get a sandwich and shit. I'm looking like this motherfucker went, then he say, man, I bought me a few of them motherfuckers to make sure that we can get what the fuck we going
absolutely.
At.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? And Eric, this man right here, he can tell you all about that struggle, man. You know what I'm saying? Just from, and being able to be humble with that shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, I'm like, these kids today's AAU basketball shit, what do you think that you would have been today as far as if AAU was like it was now?
Right.
So opportunities, you know what I'm saying? Tennis shoe contracts and all that shit. Like, what do you think you'd have been right now as far as if that shit was back then?
Well, you know, you got to do like almost like Charles Barkley said, man. You think your mama had you too early. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because they just throwing money out there right now. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people deserve it, though. But, you know, it's a totally different era as back then than it is now with the kids. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, but like you said, though, man, I if we all work together and give back, just like my man Daryl, man, I had my man Daryl. Daryl Cruz with me in Italy, man, for about a month. Mm-hmm. I flew Daryl out there and tried, you know, get Daryl the job, too, man. We stayed out there. We worked out with my team, man, for about a whole month. Daryl will tell you, man, that's just how I am, man. If anybody I mess with, I fuck with, if I can get somebody in there, I want everybody to get a piece.
Right.
You know, I don't try to say, well, I don't want this guy, I don't want that guy. Anybody I can help, I try to help, man. And that's how I always been, man. That's why I've been cool with everybody. I ain't never had no problems with nobody because, you know, I've been cool with everybody, bro. You know what I mean?
How was it like playing with John Thompson?
Big J, I mean, to be honest with you, man, John Thompson was a good role model, a good coach. You know what I mean?
Role model before coach?
Yeah, yeah. Because he wanted to see you to do good. You know what I'm saying? I give him all the respect. And then on top of that, man, just a week, 2 weeks before I got drafted, believe it or not, Houston called John. So they called John, just asked him about some stuff that happened back in the day. And John was like, man, I messed up. That was a good player. That was my man. You know what I'm saying? Woo, woo. And you know, I had a feeling I was going to go to Houston because I went to Houston 3 times to go work out.
Right.
So I had a feeling that's what I was going to end up going.
Right.
But so I got a lot of respect for Coach, man. Coach was a great coach, man. But it worked out for me better by getting away because I got to play my real game when I went to Oklahoma.
Right.
I didn't really get to play my real game when I was at Georgetown. You know what I'm saying? I mean, so that...
What's your real game, though?
You always
thought you could be a god, though.
You got to ask a lot of people who played against
me. I'm asking you. Game. What's your real game?
Well, when you get a chance, ask people that played against me. They'll tell you.
What's your real game?
Let me call some people.
But look, who would you call, though?
One of y'all guys I had, I'm going to call Mike. Mike, I got to get that straight. Mike, now, Mike Graham is my man. Mike Graham is my man.
There you go. Now we talking.
But Mike said he wore me out. I tore Mike. Mike, you know I tore you up. I tore you up, Mike. You my man. But Mike, Mike, you couldn't do nothing with it. Oh, but you my boy, though, Mike. You my boy. I love you.
just let y'all know, JT got 4 fouls right now. He about to foul out. Hey, Mike Graham, man, don't let this be the only motherfucking night that you don't come into this show, motherfucker. And JT letting your motherfucking ass know what's up. And Mike, don't start that bullshit. I'm going to tell you that right now, Mike. Come on with this bullshit, Mike. Cause you was on this show. You said, could none of them niggas fuck with you. And JT right here is saying, hey, man, you know, talk to me, Mike Graham, looking for you, baby.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Other no bullshit, though. Nah, Mike Graham, bad motherfucker, though, man.
Mike tough.
How you, did you play against Dave Butler?
Yeah, played against Big Dave.
Okay, what was the result of that?
You see.
Oh my goodness! See the shit I'm trying to see.
Nah, because y'all asked a question that y'all already know.
No, I don't know.
You do know.
The people don't know.
Yeah, the people don't. Everybody down there used to be down at Herbo knew what the results when Jay walked in the building. You know what I'm saying?
No, so, I know.
And Dave, you know, Dave was my man, but you know, a lot of big guys couldn't really mess with me in the city, man. But it was all right though. You know, I respect a lot of them and everything, and they respected me. But they know the Herbo was just JT.
Thank you. Yeah. What about Gerard Mustaf, though? I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like,
can't do that while I'm trying to drink, man. Gerard was a god, though.
Oh, shit.
No, I thought he was.
He said a god.
No, Gerard was nice, man.
Gerard was nice, man.
Gerard played 3 and 4. He played mostly 3, though. It was nice. He was real nice. Gerard was good, man.
Gerard or Emmy Tucker?
Oh, Tuck. Okay. Yeah, Tuck. Yeah, got to go with my man Tuck.
Yeah.
You know?
This motherfucker. This ain't a joke. Gerard or Daryl Prue?
Prue Tuck.
You taking Prue's run?
Yeah, Prue Tuck.
Ooh, I got a good one for you, man. And then we're going to talk about some other shit. Fred McCoy or Daryl Prue?
I don't eat all the pins.
Oh, here we go. Hey, yo, JT, you the... It all depends what Fred McCoy you talking about. Because if Fred serious, if Fred, then Fred want to be a god, too. You know, Fred, Big Fred to bring it down, court, throw it through his leg, throw it behind his back. So that pins what Fred McCoy you talking about.
No, the serious Fred McCoy. That's my man Fred. I gotta go with Daryl on that one though.
Well, why the fuck you go through all this water pills with Fred? Fred you
because
talking
because
about?
No Fred as a god, I go with Fred if you gonna play god.
He says.
Let me fix it. He never changed.
No, man. Oh man, that's right, y'all. You know what I'm saying?
He said, Kirk, he can't believe it. Yo, Kirk, come on. You know you play with Fred. You can play god, man.
Fred McCoy, bad motherfucker.
It's bad motherfucker.
Yeah.
Big Fred, that's my man.
Can
man.
Boogie.
Can get it.
Fred, Boogie, man.
Yeah. Told y'all I'm gonna have some fun
so
on the show tonight.
Poncho Hodges said, what's up, man?
Huh?
Poncho Hodges said, what's up?
Oh, tell my man what's up. What's up, Big
Poncho?
My man.
Big
that's my boy.
Man, Poncho Hodges a dirt channel, nigga.
In that sting, Poncho.
Poncho Hodges a dirt channel.
Who you get?
Oh, I like that one. I like how you did.
No, I'm saying who you get. Look, he can't even keep. Who you got? Who you got?
I got Poncho Hodges.
Yeah, that's one more.
You gotta go with Poncho. That's easy. We gotta get hard questions. You
said Poncho Hodges or James Bryson?
Oh, I gotta go Poncho.
Gotta go Poncho. Now James Bryson can get it. He can boogie, man. James, that's my man. He can boogie.
Yeah.
But Poncho, yeah.
So. James, coming to the show so I can ask him this shit again.
This boy right here, boy. Funny as it is. It's a good show, though, man. It's a great show. Man.
Nah, we even having fun, man.
I swear y'all do, around. Man. I'm serious.
You know, some dudes getting
I can't wait to Mike comment. Wait, Mike ain't comment yet? Nah, Mike ain't comment yet.
Hey, you know what I'm saying? We just had some fun on the show, man.
Oh, man.
You know what I'm saying? So, as a coach, JT, John Thompson or Mr. Price?
Oh, shit. I got to go Price.
Okay.
Price let me do my thing, man. You know what I'm saying? Not John did, but Price let me do my thing. So, I'm going with Coach Price.
He lets you, like, explain your game.
Well, yeah, let me do. John had me doing most of, you know, stuff just around the basket. Price let me come out and try to get me prepared for the next level. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
so
right.
That was the difference because I've always been fast. You know what I'm saying? I can run this, that, and the third. And I don't always gotta sit around that basket.
Right,
so that's
right.
The difference. You know what I'm saying? So I gotta go with Coach Price on that one.
Right. Right.
You know.
I mean, I always agree with the coach that's gonna let you. Play your game.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Prepare you for the next level.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that's a great thing. You know what I'm saying? Who was on your team at Roosevelt in high school? Any standout names? Did you have a good team?
Well, we had
that was 86, right?
Yeah, 86. We had like Keith DeVoe, you know what I'm saying, Scotty Benson, you know, Dale, Novell, Jay Statton.
Man, can them motherfuckers play?
Yeah, they can play, man. It's just that they didn't, you know, that was my team.
Yeah, Keith DeVoe said what's up, man. I talked to him.
Yeah, that's my man, Keith. Yeah, you know, that's
my team. What about your Cap Classic team?
Cap Classic?
Capital Classic team, but we had a nice team, man. JR was my man, man. JR Reed. Now he can
get it.
Yeah, he can get it. JR, you know, big boy, Steve, you know.
There's five. JT got five fouls, y'all. I'm just letting y'all know.
I got five. What I get, six?
Yeah, you get six. You gonna foul out, I know. Hey, man, oh boy, this true story, man. That time it's like a while ago, the Ken League was like, when Jeff Brooks called me, he said, man, get your best team to play against these dudes, man. They got a team. They had Steve Francis, Lawrence Moten, I want to say, Vanderpool. Was Vanderpool that team? Moochie Norris, Benny Keezy, what's the big boy? Jihadi White. Mm-hmm. A team full of pros, and I called you. Let me call my veterans. I called you, my brother Smith.
Right.
Bootney, Tillman, Speedy Jones, a couple other guys, and Jeff Brooks actually asked me, he said, man, you serious? He said, you ones gonna beat the shit out y'all. I say, Jeff Brooks, if you want this shit to be like the way it's supposed to be, call somebody else, motherfucker. I said, I just set up a list of some proven bad motherfuckers that we ain't even tripping off these motherfuckers.
Exactly.
You know, some proves on that team too.
Yeah.
So Jeff kind of like, man, damn, man. When I tell them who they playing against, they gonna be like, man, we gonna. I said, well, Jeff, if you think they gonna bark about that shit, it's best you don't tell them.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because them motherfuckers might tell you.
Right.
That they don't want to play these motherfuckers.
Exactly.
And that motherfucking game went up. And I'm looking at the lineup, right? I see motherfucking Jihadi White, that motherfucker.
I frustrated the shit.
Oh, man. I look, JT told the whole huddle, man, I don't want no help. Don't need no help.
I frustrated. Man,
them motherfuckers. Them motherfuckers right there. Man, I looked at that motherfucker. I think it was Bootney. Like, Joe, these motherfuckers in that paint, man. These motherfuckers elbowing, pushing motherfuckers, man. JT handled that motherfucker, man. This motherfucker's 7 foot. 3,000 pounds.
Big heavy dude, man. He was getting frustrated.
Yeah.
Ball out because he's mad. Because remember, I kept hitting him, let him go. You know, I learned that from Kim Elijah.
He kept traveling.
Yeah, because I was putting that weight on him. I let go of him. I
say, man, these motherfuckers on this motherfucker. Yeah, I said right then and there. I said, this motherfucker JG serious than the motherfucker, man. And that's no bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Like playing for Mr. Kitchens with that. You know, Kitchens ain't go for a lot of shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, his AAU practices, man, was like you practicing with colleges and shit.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Keep making sure you in shape, cussing motherfuckers out and all that shit, man. I think y'all had a nice mob. That Sunny Hill joint y'all took up there, man.
Kitchen was, and Mr. Holmes was up there, you know. Yeah. Like, something to tell you, told Mr. Holmes.
Rodney Holmes.
Man, was a good coach, man. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I got a lot of respect.
Rodney Holmes, y'all point guard, I think, I want to say.
Yeah. I got a lot of respect for Mr. Holmes, man, because he was one of the ones, too, that picked me up, man. You know, they had, like I said, Rodney Holmes. They had your boy Mike Sumner, you know. Mm-hmm. I'm still kind of mad about Mike. Y'all beat us, man, but Mike didn't win the championship that year.
Yeah,
man. Can't believe that, man.
Yeah.
Mike,
they had a nice mob,
though. Our mob couldn't mess with their mob.
Mike White, Mike Sumner, Keith Williams, Clarence Alford.
Yeah, what's
that? They had a nice little mob.
What's your boy, went to Maryland, too. Played in league for a while.
What was a youngin'? They had a mob.
Yeah, they had a good mob.
They beat us, man.
You know,
but see, they should have beat y'all, JT, because you named seven motherfuckers in your team, and you ain't said they can play or not.
No, they was all right. But that was all right. I was trying to figure out why Mike had everybody on me.
They wanted to win that game.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Oh, they was double team and all this shit.
I had all four of them was on me. And y'all know what I don't know why they didn't check the rest of my team, but it was all right. They won though. They won. That was a good game. That was a good game.
They had to stop JG.
Absolutely. They beat us by like 2 or 3 points, man. A PG college. I'll never forget that game, man. I gotta do a rematch.
This nigga's do a rematch.
Oh man, I told you we had some fun, man.
Yeah, we definitely had some fun, man.
So how was that, man, coming, like, being like Lonzo? A lot of people know, like, I know, you know what I'm saying, you was like Lonzo Matumbo's mentor up that joint. You know what I'm saying? That summer, prior to that, I mean, I see, you know, y'all was taking care of them guys. You know what I'm saying? You had Matumbo with you damn near every goddamn day.
Yeah, man. You know that's my boy, man. Especially Zoe. Me and Zoe and Matumbo, man, always just to try to hang out, be together with the big guys on the campus and everything, man. So it was a good thing, man. It was a real. I had a good time with George Sam, but I had an even better time when I went to Houston, though. I learned a lot from Akeem Olajuwon, Otis Thorpe. They taught me a lot too, man. So that was a good thing there, man. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, I remember that motherfucking day. This is some funny shit. I don't know if you remember when Matumbo, you brought the motherfucker over the house. We went over motherfucking Landover Mall.
Yeah.
Long ass time ago, and going to the little store, the Big and Tall store, to get some suits. And Matumbo had about $200 motherfucking dollars on him, picked up about 8 suits. And the motherfucker was like, man, fill his paperwork out.
Oh, man.
You remember that, though, boy?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
No bullshit.
Oh, man.
The nigga told me, Matumbo, look, fill out this paperwork, and we can put you. And for that, man, I'm saying, to see that, though, for real, man, to see that, and to see where Matumbo at today and where you at today, that's crazy, man, to see that shit from the struggle from having nothing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. To getting what the fuck you want.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That ain't nothing but like hard work.
Yeah.
And I don't think these kids know what hard work means today. It's like, because everything is given to them. Like, exactly. Frank Martin said some shit that made so much sense, man, that I don't think, like, nobody ever noticed that shit for a while. Frank Martin said, you know how you get in conversations, go, oh, man. Well, I'm guys with me talking. Oh, boom, man, you don't know, man. The game changed. The kids changed. Woo. All this bullshit. Frank Martin said some shit the other day. Said, ain't no motherfucking kids don't even know how to change.
Right.
Kids are fucking kids.
Right.
The culture's changed.
Right.
To cater to this bullshit.
Right.
So what these kids doing now, they know that shit. You know, they know that shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So You can't sugarcoat this bullshit with these youngins, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? These youngins ain't work hard. It's everything's getting like during the course of the year, real talk. Your Roosevelt season, you doing your thing. How many pair of tennis shoes you get that year? Just from like, you know, just here. Or did you have to fucking wait?
Oh, you had to wait, man. My grandma had to go up to, you know, yeah. and you know, because I was a 15-2 shoe, so they were just current 15s around. So I had to, you know, this Lando Mall was open. So, you know, wait 2 or 3 months for another pair of tennis shoes.
Hey, you know what, man, you know this shit is, man. They just...
They go out and they buy it. But you know what was wrong with the
not
kids?
Not even buying it. I'm talking about these programs. Yeah.
I'm going to tell you what I see with a lot wrong with a lot of the kids, though, man. It's, you got all these video games now, yeah. You know, you got all these, everybody got the cell phones, nobody really want to be dedicated into the gym how we was.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? So everybody want to sit at home and play video games now.
They got too much to do right now.
Yeah, exactly. You know what I'm saying? When before all that was, you know, everybody want to be in the gym playing ball and you know, I used to be around Glen Arden, man, when the rec closed, I'd be outside still working out. You know, but now kids want to come home from school, after practice and get right on the video game. They don't want to continue on. You got to continue on, man, if you want to keep on going, you know? That's what I think.
I mean, that's actually what it is. They got too much other shit to do other than just going to get better at something.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? As far as, like, you know, activity, as far as sports and shit.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I definitely get that. We got Carolina that won that game, huh?
Yeah,
Carolina Gonzaga. That's gonna be a good game.
Morgan had three chances to win.
Gonzaga Monday night.
That's gonna be a good game. I might have to go with Gonzaga, man.
I'm telling you, boys. I try to tell Gonzaga gonna do it.
You like Gonzaga? I like Carolina ACC, man.
Right.
I go with the ACC.
You want Carolina?
Yeah, I got Carolina.
Okay. So I got Gonzaga.
And
you going back because you hit Oregon.
I lost. I'm trying to get back.
I'll think about that.
Let's bet one red cup off that game. I got we bet a red cup one. I would definitely take that bet right there. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
You got to drink out a blue cup.
That's what you bet. So next week, whoever loses going to have a blue cup.
Got to have a blue cup.
That's a bet.
I got a question for you.
What's up, JG?
Kirk Smith or Mucci Norris?
I'm going with Kirk Smith all day long in a boom. I don't give a fuck who you say. Mucci bad boy.
Yeah, yeah.
No question. You know what I'm saying? No question. But I'm going to have to go with myself, though, JT.
Okay.
I'm going to have to go with myself on that one.
Just ask you that.
No, that's a good goddamn
what
question.
What top five we got for JT?
Top five?
No disrespect.
No disrespect as far as like what? All right, well, yeah. That was a good one.
Which one is that?
Yeah. No disrespect.
No disrespect.
You know what I'm saying? Bootney Green or Lawrence Moten? See, jump out there.
I gotta go with Bootney Green.
Okay.
Yeah. I gotta go with Clarence.
Much respect.
Experience always over top. You know what I mean?
Clarence brought a lot to the game too. You know what I'm saying? He can board. Intensity
and
game.
Ain't no disrespect, cause I fuck my boy Lawrence Moten. That's my man. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But I just seen what Bootney can do out there, and he's still doing it at past 50.
Yeah, no bull.
You know what I'm saying?
No bullshit.
Yeah,
I definitely respect that. Mm-hmm. Earl Moore or Henry Hall?
I'm going with Henry Hall.
Okay.
I'm going with Henry Hall. I spent the summer with that kid, man, of Georgetown, you know, in 87. Then I always kept wondering, who was this kid, Henry Hall, who keep on chasing my scoring title for PG? Cause that dude, you see, you know, and I found out it was Henry Hall, and you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I got to go with Henry on that one.
Yeah, Henry bad motherfucker.
Yeah.
Henry Chow. You give him a question, Mo. Like you give him a no disrespect question as far as, like, comparing a player or two.
No disrespect? Mike Smith or John Turner?
Woo! Man, that might have been disrespectful.
No disrespect.
Without the no.
Yeah. Mike, you want to tell him or you want me to tell him? My boy Mike, man. You know I gotta fuck with my boy Mike, man. Yeah. Mike, my man, man. That's my man. You know, we have a good time having fun on the show, man. You know, I knew you were gonna laugh at that joint. Yeah, pick a phone up, right?
That nigga say, Mike, you want me to. Hey, that boy, you a wild man. You ain't answered that question yet, though.
Oh, no, you know, I'm going to me. You know that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Donald Hard or Gerard Mustafa?
Who?
Donald Hard or Gerard Mustafa?
I'm going to have to go with Gerard on this one, though.
Okay.
Donald Hard can get it. Donald Hard can definitely boogie. But I got to go with Gerard.
Yeah, I was going to boogie. I think Mustafa, like, all around.
Right.
Mm. You know what I'm saying? That might shoot the J. You know what I'm saying?
And I don't know what... Because sometimes Donald come out there. Donald's game is so sweet. He just be laughing a lot, having a good time.
Right.
He don't really, you know, put it all in. Donald Hard's really...
JC got 9 fouls, y'all.
If Donald Hard put on that... If he put on the energy, man, how he built a court, man, Donald Hard's a bad boy, man.
Nah, Donald's a boogie. Donald, yeah. Nah, Donald. Yeah.
He didn't take it as serious as he wanted to. If he took it real serious,
I definitely agree with that.
Yeah, Dollar was a bad boy, man.
I definitely agree with that. Yeah. For sure.
He just ain't take it as serious as he should have, man. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Dollar moves like a motherfucker.
I got one. Sherman Douglas or Charles Smith?
Man, oh man. So you asking me first?
I'm going
Charles Smith.
Okay, I respect
that. I ain't going to think about that one.
I respect that.
Charles Smith. Okay. All right.
That's a good one.
What you think?
Smitty. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because you know what I'm saying? Everything's no disrespect.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and that's a great question, though.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you got two good point guards. Yeah,
two bad motherfuckers.
And then, I mean, especially when we played the Syracuse and Georgetown.
You ain't lying about that shit.
Yeah.
Victor Page or Greg Jones?
Greg Jones.
Okay.
Gotta go with my man Greg.
Okay.
Yeah.
Lonnie Real or Greg Jones?
Man. That's a good one.
Yeah.
That's a good one because both of them get down. Yes, both of them can get down.
Yeah.
Lonnie game, which is so sweet, man. His size, handle the ball, and can shoot and go to the basket. I'm going to go with Lonnie on this one, though.
You and Lonnie, that's a good move.
That's a good move.
Mm-hmm. That's a good move.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
That's what
I'm saying. D. Scott, 3D. What's up, big fella? How you been, man? Good to see you chiming in, champ. Got your man JT right here. You know what I'm saying? We got some Greg Jones fans here, too, now, though, JT. God damn.
Greg was a bad boy.
Yes, he was.
No doubt about it. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Boy's bad. No bullshit.
Yeah, absolutely. Greg can get down, man.
Yeah, no bullshit. Dennis Scott or Walt Williams?
I'm got to go with my boy Dennis, man, on that one. Okay. You know, no disrespect my man Walt, but Dennis is my teammate, man. Got to go with my teammate. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no disrespect. I gotta go with. You said Dennis Scott and Walt Williams.
Okay.
I gotta go with my man Dennis Scott. You know what I'm saying? We played together. You know, so.
Right. Yeah. Greg did put that motherfucking move on plenty of that herbo though.
Yeah. Greg was a bad boy.
No question.
Greg was a bad boy.
No question. Greg Jones or Bootney Green, John Turner.
Gotta go with my man Clarence on this one.
Yeah.
Gotta go with Clarence on that one.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah. Clarence always take it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So let me see here, man. Yeah.
Donald Ford or Walt Williams, that's a good one, but I'm gonna have to go with Walt on that one. I mean, Walt.
Yeah, I love Donald.
Yeah,
Wizard.
I think Donald was before his time. You know what I'm saying? I think Walt was more so in the mix with what was going on, you know what I'm saying, after high school and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But Walt was good in shit in high school. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Donald Ford and Michael Tate should be the question in high school. Yeah. I ain't seen too many motherfuckers.
Mike Tate.
Fuck with Michael Tate.
I'm going to tell you, this for real. Mike was 2 years behind us.
Mm-hmm.
But he might have been the only one who's giving me a little bit of problems. Just a little bit. I'm going to give you a little bit of problems, Mike.
He got a tech. And we can keep him in the game.
I'm going to give him a little bit of problems.
He paying
you know
fines.
Yeah. I'm going to give Mike a little bit of problems.
Paying fines, man.
But I'm saying he was tough, though. Tate was tough.
Now, Mike's athletic.
Yeah.
Shoot that little baseline J. Mike Tate was a bad motherfucker.
He was. I said to myself, I'm going to try to see if I foul Mike because he red if he turned red.
Mike was tough though. He wasn't scared out there, motherfucker.
Mike Tate
was tough and shit though. Tucker was tough in high school too though.
Oh yeah, Tucker, yeah.
Yeah, Tucker was tough in high school too.
Lando Vega.
Oh man, yes, sir. Lando played Julio?
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, Julio was tough. Top five player JT played against a high school, man.
Keep DeVoe asking you.
Yeah. Well, Keith, he played on your team. He couldn't remember y'all names, man. So, man. So I respect
that man lied.
Hey, Keith, I respect the question though. No disrespect. I'm just saying.
I mean, be honest with
you. So that's a good question.
The boy lied to you, Keith. Rewind the tape, you'll see. I said y'all name, brother. He wanna play with you, Keith.
Whoa. He out.
No, he's gonna find me, man.
He's gonna find me. Okay.
The top five players
that I played in high school.
Against?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with Tate. I'm gonna go with Jay Bies.
A lot of people forget about Jay too.
Yeah, a lot of people forget about Jay. Go with Jay. I'm gonna go with I ain't ready to play against, but I'm gonna go with you, my man Henry Hall, Clint Venable. You know,
somebody Coco put up Brian Davis on there.
Yeah, Brian Davis was tough too. It was Maryland. We had in the high. Y'all thought y'all was the shit, man. I wish we could have played y'all more, man. That'd have been good.
JT, I tell you,
that'd have been good.
Hey, JT, back in that time, I wasn't there that time.
I know you weren't there.
They were swarming back there, though, JT. They would beat the shit out of them PG County schools.
No.
Until back then, I'm saying.
They probably did once y'all stopped playing.
No, once you were playing, they was mollywopping.
You know what I'm kind of mad about you? I need to call and watch the post. Matter of fact, I'm going to call them later on tomorrow and tell them there ain't nowhere in the world I'm supposed to be on second team. I supposed to be on first team. You see the people that were first team over me?
Yeah.
No disrespect to everybody that made first team over me. But y'all know better.
You're right.
Yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? But I just think that was because it was DC thing instead of Maryland. Because that's crazy.
You absolutely right about that.
You know what I mean?
You're absolutely right about that.
Huh?
Glenn Sidney was two-time first team around the time.
Glenn Sidney was after me, though. He was like, you know what I'm saying?
But that's the German boy, right?
Yeah.
He was pretty good.
But he wasn't me, though.
Nah, he wasn't no.
So, you know, he just, I was so hurt about that when I seen the 86 joint. I said, that's crazy, man. But it worked out for the best, though. It worked out for the best. You know, that gave me that drive.
Right.
I gotta ask Kirk a question too, man. Let me see here, man.
Hey, JT. JT. One thing about me, I ain't ducking.
I hope you ain't ducking.
You are Kirk
Smith or Eminem?
Eminem who? Mel Medicine?
Yeah, come on, man.
Oh,
let me see your phone real quick. you want him to tell you motherfucker with the you want yeah. Girl, nah, Mel my boy. Yeah, that's my boy though. Actually, to be honest with you, man, I've actually learned a lot from Mel as far as like just from a point guard,
right?
You know, perspective that the one thing that I learned from Mel, this motherfucker show the true meaning of a point guard, because I done seen him, you know, throw some passes, mother don't catch, and to get on his players, right, and catch them up, you ain't getting them up. That's the shit I learned from him.
Right.
You got some point guards that, knowing goddamn well, if you get that motherfucker to rock, they supposed to dunk it or court it or something, and they don't say nothing to him.
Right.
Mailman had no problem. I don't give a fuck who it is.
Right.
He ain't had no motherfucking problem cussing your ass out because you ain't do the motherfucking right thing on the court. Now, I definitely learned that from him. You know what I'm saying? So, I ain't taking nothing away from no motherfucking Eminem.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, at all. But at the same time, you know, I mean, I'm going with me. You know what I'm saying? Definitely going with me on that. You tried that one, though.
But no, I'm just trying to see. I mean, I'm you know, because all of us is playing on the same squad almost. You know what I'm saying? You know, that's why, you know.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying. D. Scott, man, you see what we doing here, man. Me and JT, man, holler at me sometime, man. You know, I see you got your DC documentary basketball thing going on. I actually think that, you know what I'm saying. I don't like it though, D. Scott.
You ain't going to the right people on that one, but I respect it. You know what I'm saying? We're going to sit down and talk, man. You know what I'm saying? That's what we going to do with Dennis Scott. You know what I'm saying? But this motherfucker 3D shoots that motherfucker, man. I done seen this motherfucker, man, come down and, man, from that motherfucker 3D shoots that motherfucker. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, he was a matchup problem with a lot of guys in the city.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Back in the day, they were saying he was the next Adrian Dantley and all that. You know what I'm saying? To even be Adrian Dantley name comparable, you know what I'm saying? That's tough, man. You know what I'm saying? I got a chance to see Dennis play with y'all. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
On that Kitchens mob. Y'all had a mob. You know what I'm saying? Y'all had a mob. You need we could make it 3 hours, though, if D's got on a story about the D.C. shit. If you come and holler at the right people, man. You know what I'm saying? And I need you on the show whenever you get a chance, man. You know? And that's no bullshit. You my man. You know that. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we got my man JT right here, man.
That's all you had to do is give me, you know what I'm saying? You know what? That's it. That's my man. Mm-hmm. Big D, man. Tell moms to say what's up, man. You know,
he fouled out. He just hey, JT just fouled out of the game. You know what I'm saying? Big D and all this, man. We, you know.
Y'all are disrespectful, man. Y'all, Lord have mercy, y'all disrespectful.
Now we had 250. Two games.
Me go ahead and pay my fine.
Yeah. Motherfucker, man, JT though, man. Yeah, you know, but y'all ran through that motherfucking Big East that year though. How the fuck y'all lose to Duke? Just keep it real. We started up the show with that.
Alright.
Then you actually try to like get Zoe a pass. Layton ran through that motherfucker, man.
Layton had a good game.
Okay.
Everybody tied it to a good game. I held Danny Furry, he ain't do nothing. You know what I'm saying? Danny, if you're looking at the show, be honest with yourself. So, you know. You know what I'm saying? So, Layton had a great game, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, him and Zoe was rookies. You know what I'm saying? Freshmen. And he had a great, great game, man. And he hurt us. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, we was, like I said, we ran through the Big East like it wasn't nothing.
Yeah, y'all damn sure did. You know what I'm saying? Oh, Michael Gill, one of the baddest motherfuckers that come through here for that motherfucking 3-4 combo, 2 whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Revisit week. Mike Gill.
Yeah. Mike Gill or Donald Ford, though, Charlie Mo?
Mike Gill or Donald Ford?
Mm-hmm.
Man, give me...
Yeah, I mean, you know what I'm saying? I think that's a good goddamn question.
That's a great question.
Yes, it
is. I'm going D-Ford on that one.
Okay.
You know, I D4 can boogie. Y'all must ain't really see. D4
can play.
Yeah, man. He gets down with it, man.
Mike Gill, I'm trying to tell y'all, man. Later on. But look here. Mike Gill's a bad motherfucker, too, though, JT.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Who
you taking, Mo?
You ain't pick yet. Yeah. He going to say, huh? Yeah, he ducking
that question. Who you taking? Well, I take on that one. Give me D4, man.
Man,
D4, now only because I
Mike Gill said you don't know who he is because he's younger.
Mike Gill, bad motherfucker. I'm not taking nothing away from you, young fella, but D4 can straight up get it too.
I'm going with the thrill, man.
Well, see,
I'm going with the thrill, man.
He going to see.
You can't go wrong.
That's what I'm saying. But overall, I'm gonna have to go with the thrill because the one thing the thrill going to do is give you a whole arsenal of playing a 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Donald might play the 1 or the 2 or 3, but Gill just way more athletic than Donald was.
Yeah.
I mean, like, it ain't close to athleticism.
Yeah, no way.
You know what I'm saying? And the one thing that Gill gonna do, Gill gonna play way more. No, nothing against Donald Ford. You know, he's a bad motherfucker. I think that Mike Gill gonna bring more energy to the game than Donald Ford will. And he's way more athletic. You know what I'm saying? Mike Gill, bad motherfucker.
Yeah, shit.
Yeah.
I know that.
Yeah, Mike Gill, bad motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? No, off the no bullshit. I got to know him, JT, though. You know what I'm saying? I like how you jumping out there, though.
Absolutely. I told you, man, I would bring attention to you, man. When you made that phone call, said, Jay, you coming? I said, man, I'm coming.
Oh, man.
You know what I'm saying? I told you I was coming.
500.
Told him I was coming. Now go ahead.
750.
I got Kirkle. I got it. That's my man right here.
750.
Oh, man.
Come on, man. Give me the question, dog. I got to get this question.
750. Oh, man.
He don't want to give me the question. I'm asking for the question. My man. Can I get the question, please, sir?
The question is...
Okay.
All right. Kurt Bone Chain was a Rafael Edmund.
Let me think about that one right there.
Yeah.
I don't have neither one of them number. Look at this.
Nah, man.
See what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You told me we're going to keep it real. This is the Keep It Real show. What's in the bathroom? I'm going to go see what's in the bathroom. I want to see what he got in the bathroom.
Oh, that's a G. That's a G. You're up to a G.
Oh, man, I like it. This joke right here is fun, man.
This is crazy, man.
This was fun, man. I'm going to go home. This was fun.
Yeah, man.
This was fun, man. I'm serious. This was fun, man. I ain't going to lie. Y'all some good dudes, man. Y'all some real good dudes, man. Telling y'all, man. This is a fun show. You know, it was real nice, man. You know, chilling with the fellas and everything, talking, laughing, and joking.
Oh, man. Great.
But Kirk just don't want to keep it real. I got to give him a fine, man, of $500. You know what I'm saying?
That's the JT I know.
$500 and two shirts.
And two shirts.
Oh, man. You know I like to have fun, man. You know how we was having fun. We was having fun, dog. Man, all we did was laugh and joke, man. That's all we did, man.
I'm going to tell you that motherfucking summer, right? There's some funny shit, right? We were down Shamrock. Him and Smith, they play the same tune with Italy and shit, you know what I'm saying? These motherfuckers come back in town, these motherfuckers got all this motherfuckers, we in the crap games and shit, just, the crap game end up to just them two motherfuckers shooting hunters and shit. I'm on the side of my man, find somebody to bet 5 foot, they can't find nobody that I'm like, fucked up. But in my mind, I'm saying, whichever one of these motherfuckers win, I'm gonna be good. Cause they gonna break that motherfucking bread off, and we gonna have a good motherfucking time tonight. Them two niggas right there, boy, him and Smith.
I'm gonna tell you, man.
Some funny motherfuckers, man.
Man, Smitty.
No bullshit, hey, man.
Me and Smitty had a good time, man. We was in Italy together. We had a good motherfucking time. But I'm gonna tell y'all, man. Real life. Me and Smith, we turned to 50, so y'all better come out there with us, man. We great turn 50.
Oh, y'all birthday like a day after each other,
day
right?
Apart, man. We great do it. Me and Smitty going to do something real big. That's all I'm going to say. I'm going to leave it alone, but it's going to be real big, man. We both turn 50 one day apart from each other.
That's in like the November joint, right? November, 29th yeah. And 30th.
Yep.
Right, yeah. Right. You know they can come and support
yeah.
Y'all.
Yeah.
No, you know they're going to do that, man. So who you think should be Georgetown's next coach, JT?
Well, I took myself out of the picture. nah, for real though, man. that was a good question though. But I did take myself out. But I'm gonna tell you for real, man, I like Tommy Amaker, man. I do like Tommy Amaker.
Yeah, I like Tommy.
And I do like Johnny, you know what I'm saying? Dawkins, I do, you know what I'm saying? I think both of the guys be good candidates, man. You know what I'm saying? For Georgetown job, man.
Right.
I don't know if they're in the picture or if they, you know what I mean? Yeah, they live, but they have a good job.
They in there. Yeah, they in there. Okay. What do you think about Pat Ewing getting the job up there?
I think Pat want to stay in the league. You know what I'm saying? I think he.
What do you think would be a good move for Georgetown, though?
I think be a good move for one of the people that, one of them two, them because they in college already. You see what I'm saying?
Right. So, I'm talking about Pat Mill. Would it be a good move to have Pat?
I don't think it'd be a good move with Pat.
I actually, I totally agree with you.
Yeah, because Pat, he's been in the league for a long time. And with
this college shit now, you have to already be in this shit to know this shit.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
You can't come with that NBA mentality and think you can go in that. It's
two different things.
One thing, because it's rules to it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And then you playing that zone and all that.
All that shit. You got to ask the people. You know what I'm saying? You got to...
It's different styles. It's different attitudes. Yeah. It's different restrictions.
Avery, you know what I'm saying? Made a good adjustment.
Yeah, but yeah. Avery, one of the type of guys that can do that, though. Yeah.
Right.
Because he's more so a people's person. He's spiritual.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He's very impatient with his job and everything. A guy from Pat to come from that league, when you coaching motherfuckers that make way more than you, you know what I'm saying? And you ain't got to say so. But at the same time, you ain't got to worry about a motherfucking SAT test.
Yep.
You ain't got to worry about a goddamn breaking a violation. You can go out to eat with these niggas. You can go out and get fried with these niggas. You can do all that shit. So to go from that level to NCAA, I'm not a big fan of that.
Mike Dunleavy just took his first coaching job. I got a buddy on the staff, and they adjusting to it.
Right. It's a long adjust. You can't go with that mentality. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? JC, after the game, you can go meet your coach for a beer or a drink or something, but you can't do them kids.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Exactly. But then you got to know the rules of the game, who you can recruit.
But then both of them coming from two good coaches. You know what I'm saying? Johnny coming in from
You know what I'm saying?
So he know how to coach. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I think it'd be a real good move for Johnny.
It'd be a great move.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I think it's a great move for them because any guy that has college experience on a high level, I think Georgetown is the goddamn dream job for right now.
Right.
From that job being opening right now for any coaches right now that has college experience and got a little name, whoever take that job and run with that shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because, you know, like a lot from what I hear, a lot of people won't take the job because they think Big John's still involved and they got to answer to him.
Right.
Things like that. But I think if Georgetown take a whole new culture, you know what I'm saying, and anybody if they not worried about being a Georgetown family because which it doesn't really have a huge family tree because the only people that coaches there was his sons,
right? Mm-hmm.
Versus two Coach K prepared them guys,
right? Mm-hmm.
All them guys went off and got head coaching jobs,
right?
And they're fully prepared to coach at a big major university to get that shit back. You know what I'm saying? I think that's a dream job for the next motherfucker, to be honest with you. You know what I'm saying? Because they've been competitive. It's a bigger school. Big conference, and they stay competitive. You know what I'm saying? And coming off the bullshit year they're having, you know?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, that's just what I think about the job. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
It'd be interesting, man. It'd be real interesting.
Very motherfucking interesting.
They need to put somebody real that can deal with the kids, know how to handle it, you know what I mean?
Right.
Because I'm seeing Georgetown losing a lot of good players coming from the city, too, that's going other places playing ball. Mm-hmm. That's crazy.
Yeah, they can't. Crazy. You can't get outside this motherfucker. Back in the day, you couldn't.
Right, exactly.
They stopped your ass right there at the airport, and then you going to Georgetown or Maryland.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
That's why they need to make a decision soon.
Exactly.
Right.
You got to start recruiting.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
They got like five open scholarships right now to fill for next year.
Right.
Yeah.
So it's going to end up being like a few walk-ons on the team, transfer guys, you know what I'm saying? But I think they can get it up in a few years.
They say Zoe took his son out of school.
Zoe got him out of there.
Yeah.
But I think Zoe's son could have actually went somewhere else to like a mid-major and actually played.
Right.
He's not bad. You know what I'm saying? He can play a little bit. Right, you know what I'm saying? I think that probably the Georgetown situation, legacy and all that.
Yeah.
He could have actually went somewhere else and actually played, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So getting back on the, just D.C. basketball, JT, I know you're a down the floor guy. You know what I'm saying? Lonnie the Real guy. Mm-hmm. Down the floor to Lonnie the Real.
I'm going to go with Lonnie the Real.
Okay. Explain your reason why.
Because Lonnie could do a little bit more, I think, than Donald can. I mean, both of them was good scores. But I'm saying far as like now, the three-point, I think Lonnie three-point is better than the fours. I think Lonnie can handle the ball a little bit better than the four. You know what I'm saying? But four can find his shot. Four can still score. But all around, far as all three of them, I mean, both of them could play one through the three. You know what I'm saying?
Right, I agree.
So,
definitely agree.
I had to go with Lonnie on that one, though.
Yeah, I would go with Lonnie myself on that one. Greg Jones, my man. What's up, G. Jones?
G. Jones.
My motherfucking man.
Jones.
bad motherfucker. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? DJ, I've raised him. That's my little youngin', though.
Okay.
That's my little young. Good young. That's my little young.
Okay.
Little young. Some boogie, though. Bad motherfucking boogie.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah. That's my little man. Everybody gonna Lonnie real on this one, though. I'm gonna go with Lonnie over to Donald Ford also.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I definitely agree with your point, how you made your point, though.
Yeah,
bad motherfucker. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, have you seen... You seen Tutu play, right, before?
Who?
Little Tutu.
Uh-huh.
Gary Johnson. I know you seen Tutu play before. Come on, man. Yeah.
Serious.
You never seen Tutu play before?
No.
Okay.
You got him on your phone or something?
Now, he a little younger than me. You know what? Okay. You probably haven't seen him. Shorty can book.
Okay.
Shorty can book. I was going to actually give you a comparison to him.
Right.
But you ain't seen a lot of young guys.
Right.
You seen Jason McCurry play?
Nope.
So, yeah, Jason.
See, a lot of times when I left, I left. You know what I'm saying? Back when I used to come playing Herbo and this, that, and the third, but then when they stopped Herbo, then I really wasn't watching too much, you know what I'm saying, playing no more besides going down to Georgetown and playing, so nah.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Romeo Roach, my little point guard on and off the court. You don't start that bullshit. Holler at your boy.
You better say it.
You man Charlie Moe said you better say it.
You better say it. Number 12. Holler at your boy.
Oh, man. Deepak, that's a question right there.
Yeah.
JT, baby. Similar games, though. Similar games. That's a great motherfucking question right there. JT or George Lynch? Similar game, but I got to go with JT on that one. Not because he's right here, but all around, I got to go with JT on that. I ain't got a lot of guys, man, that played that 4 and 5. You know what I'm saying? That I'm actually, you know what I'm saying? Like go with old JT. You know, I ain't saying because he's right here. You know what I'm saying? That motherfucker, he'll finish you at the rim. Sometimes get his little bullshit mode and get that rim and bring coast to coast. I'm like, hold it right here. You know what I'm saying? Wave me off and all that bullshit. You know what I'm saying? You know, then, all right, I'm going to tell you when the shit got fucked up, though. When he developed a little J, it was over. Yeah. It was over. He was knocking that motherfucker down, but at the same time, this motherfucker workhorse in that basketball and that motherfucking paint, man, no bullshit. No motherfucking bullshit, man.
I gotta answer that one. JT and Mike Graham.
Yeah. I mean, you. What I'm saying, but you calling Mike Graham out?
No, I'm just saying.
Are you calling Mike Graham out, man?
Mike, my man. That's 100 grand. That's my buddy.
Okay.
That's my man, 100 grand. That's my boy.
Mike Graham.
But Mike know that I got that ass.
That's 2 G's, man.
That man said,
hey, we gotta put this on HBO. Hey, Butterbean Pierce, you my man, champ.
Butterbean.
Butterbean, hey, Dink, don't start that bullshit, man. Dink, Butterbean Peters, or John Turner? You answer that one, nigga. You my man, homie, you know that, boy, but this is some other shit right here, man. Mm-hmm. Bad boy though, man, you know. These niggas tell me some no.
Oh man, y'all funny. They funny, boy.
Man, say
something. Man. Oh man, I gotta give me a let me see. I'm gonna say Kurt.
Hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna go with me. But I don't give a fuck what you say, JT.
Off the break, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. So go ahead.
Hey, you go with yourself already.
Yeah. Ooh, I'm gonna be. Look, Dink said he's taking himself over you though.
He's supposed to. He at home by himself. Look. Now you my man, big dog. You know I gotta steal up and mess with you, boy. Look here, man. You're supposed to take yourself. You gotta keep it real. Take yourself. That's all right. I understand that. But look, hey, you know what? You a funny dude.
man.
This motherfucking John Turner, man.
Hey, man, this is what we used to do, man. Back in 86, 85. You know, boy, sit out there on this, the porch and just laugh and joke, have fun, man, to ask everybody. Man, is it that easy?
Yeah.
That was all saying back then.
That was
all
saying.
You know what I'm saying? That was my boy.
Oh, man.
Man, this nigga crazy as shit, man. No bullshit, man.
We go with Kirk Smith from Muggsy Bowl.
What the viewers think?
You ask me?
The viewers.
Oh, ask the viewers. Go ahead, ask the viewers.
Kirk Smith from Muggsy Bowls. Don't say it because Kirk your man. Don't say it because Muggsy your man. Just
I'm going Muggsy Bowls on that one.
Okay.
Height wise, she's shorter than me.
Yeah,
I ain't going with him over me.
Yeah,
what are you going with over?
Yeah, nothing.
Okay. We'll see what the viewers say. They might have a different, you know.
Yeah. Well, you know, you the know one thing saying? See, I'm going to say, I will say this. Watching Muggsy play basketball back in the day, really, I probably was, to be honest with you, probably his number one fan as far as like just that motherfucker, see him orchestrate in a big ass conference.
Right.
To be so effective. At 5'3" and going the first round,
yeah,
that's like some unheard of shit. You know what I'm saying? So, out of all due respect, definitely, you know what I'm saying? He was one of the guys I watched playing basketball. You know what I'm saying? My first, you know what I'm saying, guy that I really patting certain parts of my game is Ducky Vaughn. You know what I'm saying? To be able to watch him play and to actually show me how to score the basketball when we was like, when we was young, going to Ducky Vaughn camp down at Melvin Crab House. And he had everybody, me, Charlie, everybody's in that camp. Yeah. And this guy's was just showing little shit, you know what I'm saying, just to, like, height ain't nothing. Like, he the first one that ever told me that shit. You know what I'm saying? And that's real talk. But to see Muggsy, first time I seen Muggsy, I heard a lot about him. First time he played was at the Capitol Center. And I want to say the Capital Class or something like that. This motherfucker was very exciting to watch play basketball. This motherfucker was short. And then to catch them games, man, on the ACC channel back when he was playing, I'm like, nigga, smart. But then when I finally got a chance, Wake Forest, yep. Yeah, you're a man. So when I finally got a chance to play against him the Herbo, you know what I'm saying? I actually got a chance to watch him play first. In person at the Herbo, you know what I'm saying? And just seeing how guys would cater to the way he played defense. You know what I'm saying? Like picking up 94 feet. Why are y'all messing with the basketball back there? Just give this, get the ball to somebody else and go sit on the block. You know what I'm saying? So that was my thing with him. So it ended up being a situation where it was a great game. You know what I'm saying? Great situation for me because I was a young guy. I just got to Drake. You know what I'm saying? End up getting 53 on him, which I expected, which wasn't surprising. You know what I'm saying? Because I had a game plan before I went to the gym and played against him. You know what I'm saying? And we was going at it. You know what I'm saying? But I always played the game as, if you got a little motherfucker on you, just go to that block. You know what I'm saying? A lot of guys took me to the block as far as like, maybe post them up. But you still got ways to get, you know, you stronger. You know how to handle block. You know what I'm saying? This block play. With him was, I had enough shit in my arsenal where I could handle the ball too. And you know what I'm saying? Like, boom, get out of the way. Shit like that. That people forget. You know what I'm saying? Like, I invented a lot of that bullshit. Like little bullshit tricks and shit as far as the hands up and all that shit. The crawls, which me and my young fella, Polish Frost, you know what I'm saying? T-Roy from down Watson, we didn't mastered that shit, you know what I'm saying, like, and put that shit on a whole nother level, you know what I'm saying, which guys like T-Ware and Posey didn't get credit for, you know what I'm saying, they was on some whole nother level with that shit, but with the Muggsy situation, I had too much shit in my arsenal to let anybody, like, really guard me back in the day, and that's like the real talk, I was unguarded, I had too much shit with me, I had too much on the block, on the perimeter. You know what I'm saying? To get somebody, like, just go ahead. You know what I'm saying? Just don't even fuck around.
Now Michael Graham's just joined.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, Michael Graham, JT in here. JT in here, Mike Graham. Mike Graham, JT say you bullshit, man. He say bust your ass. No homo.
Oh, man, that's a fine right there. Yeah, yeah, that's bust a ass.
Got one for him. You got 20 fines then.
Nah, I ain't say that like that. I just told nah,
nah, you said a lot of other shit.
Nah, I just told Mike he know I got the best of that. Mike, you know I got you. You know I got you. You know what I'm saying? You a bad boy, but you had nothing over the big dog.
Damn.
Yes, sir.
That's crazy.
Man.
Oh, he did. Okay. Come on, Mike Graham, man. It was bullshit, man. Mm-hmm. The Thrill Gill, man.
Thrill Gill.
We not leaving this show until Mike Graham comment on what John Turner just said. We ain't ducking no wreck, Mike Graham. You know what I'm saying? Well, Mike Graham, but it must be true, JT.
Yeah, it must be true.
Must be true, JT.
Breaking news. Hey, <don't... laughs> breaking news.
That was a breaking news.
Yes, indeed.
Oh, man.
Hey, we try to wait to come from Graham, but it sounds like it's true, Mike. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm here arguing with man JT like, nah, you ain't using the motherfucking Mike Graham. No, fuck no. But, I mean, you ain't saying that, man. Mm-hmm. You know?
Maybe his phone went out.
Yeah. Charge your phone up, Mike. Oh, man.
Yeah, man.
Man, y'all niggas is funny than a motherfucker.
That's a good show here today,
man. We have a good time. What time is it though?
12:10.
I am officially 46, man.
Birthday, sir.
Officially.
Man, happy birthday, man.
Officially
46,
man.
Happy birthday.
Yeah. Damn. Officially 46.
Y'all wish my man Kirk, man, a happy birthday. Turned 46 years old just now, man. 10 minutes ago, man. He's still here with us. So we want to wish my man Kirk a happy birthday, man. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Y'all chime in and wish my man a happy birthday, man.
Dickie Simpkins or John Turner? Hey, I think somebody just want to type anything in.
And, you know, ask the questions like it shouldn't even be asked. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's 12:10, and they want to ask a question like that.
Oh, man.
I can't even say it on that one, man. I'll let y'all think. I can't even say it on that. That was disrespectful. That was very disrespectful. I'm lost on that one. Damn. I might go dance. I'm going to dance on the stars or something. Cause that question there was
just, that was a bad question.
That was a bad question.
Dickie Simmons was pretty good though. He's pretty good. He had a nice little game. He had a nice game.
Okay.
James Bryson or Dickie Simmons?
I go with Dickie on that one.
Dickie Simmons was nice, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. D. Fox wonder who's your toughest opponent in the Big East, JT.
X-ray hip,
my motherfucking homie. What's up, boy?
X-ray.
JT, don't duck this question, man. My brother say, who was your toughest opponent in the Big East, man?
Toughest opponent?
You got Jerome Lane.
No, I'm going to go with my man of Syracuse.
Dirk Holman?
No.
What? Billy Owens.
Billy Owens. Billy can use both hands, left and right. I'm trying to figure out what hand he was shooting one time. Billy Owens a bad boy, man. You like Billy?
Yeah.
I can't believe you like Billy. That's my
man. Hold up, man. Oh,
man. Man, you ain't like Billy.
Where's Jay Butler at tonight, man? Hey, Jay, where you at, man? These niggas lunching.
Billy Owens, huh, man?
Oh, my goodness, man.
Billy Owens.
But yeah, now Billy Owens tough.
Yeah,
because I remember that year Billy Owens and Tucker was the shit back then.
Right.
On that little summer when they was like going into their like freshman year or something, was Tucker was tough.
Yeah.
Tucker was a bad boy, man. And Tucker was a bad boy. Who you think the purest shooter from the area though, JT? Just purest shooter, just knockdown shooter from the area. Like you know that.
I gotta go with Moore.
Earl Moore?
Earl Moore was a bad one. And then before Moore was your other boy, you know what I'm saying?
You think Earl Moore shoot that motherfucker like Henry Hall?
Damn. Nah. I go with Henry then Earl.
Okay.
Yeah. Earl was more of a scorer though. Henry was a shooter.
Right. See, Earl you know what? It's funny you said it because that's when you basketball talking basketball.
Right.
Some people take your opinions and like you lunching or whatever, but when you talking about they know the game,
right?
Like you just broke it down. You said Henry was a shooter, Earl was a
scorer.
That has a lot to do with certain opinions. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? That has a lot to do with it. You know what I'm saying? Like that's when guys talk about Greg Jones. I think Greg Jones was more of a scorer before a shooter.
Right.
But can shoot that much. Like Earl Moore and Greg remind me of each other a little bit.
Right.
They can score and shoot the ball.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And then you got guys that just can shoot the ball.
Exactly.
That don't mean they scores. Right. You know what I'm saying? It's a
difference. Two different things.
That's how you break the game. But that's when you're talking to people
that know basketball.
Somebody said Charlie Moore.
No doubt about it. Yeah. They ain't saying nothing wrong. That's what I'm saying. That's why you gotta understand the question.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You got to understand certain questions. You know what I'm saying? Like, Henry, like, okay, I'm going to go back on the show and everybody threw stones at me, right? The Henry Hall fans, which I am a big fan of Henry Hall. The question was, who am I taking Henry Hall and Mark Tillman? I said Mark Tillman, but I explained why. Only thing I said was, Mark Tillman can do more on that basketball court than Henry can do. Mark can play some defense. Mark will rebound that motherfucker, way more athletic, and can get you a dub. So if you need a dub, that's not taking nothing away from Henry. It's just saying what I think he can do more on that court.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I just think Mark can do more. Right. And then people, like I said, people forgot Mark was Mr. Basketball when he came out.
Right.
Mark was highly recruited.
Right.
That's not taking I'm saying Henry can't fuck with Mark. You know what I'm saying? I just think Mark was a better all-around basketball.
Right, exactly. Right.
But you throw Henry up to the best of him, he gonna get you 40s and all that shit. I just think Mark might get you 20, 6-7 boards, a few steals.
Right.
I'm gonna check the best nigga from a 1, 2, or 3.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Right. That's what my reason for taking Mark.
Exactly.
I got a lot of people call, man, that's fucked up, man. You took Mark. No, I wasn't saying it like that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So, I mean, that's crazy. Like, and then to go into another question with you, because I know you cool with both of these guys. Scoring the basketball, Henry Hall or Bootney Green?
Going with my man Clarence. Don't leave me, Clarence. Don't leave me. That's a damn booty thing right there, boy. Don't leave me. Don't leave me, Clarence.
Yeah, booty square, motherfucker.
Yeah, booty.
She chose me.
Yeah, you know. Yeah, booty flat out do it, man.
Yeah, flat out do it.
Yeah. Flat out do it.
But I think that's a good point. Like, if you want a motherfucker, that's going to go all out that motherfucking court and still going to get you 40.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He ideal situation for, but man, great man tonight, man, JT, this nigga funny. We still wait, Mike Graham. Don't hit me up on that Facebook shit.
Your phone
and all that bullshit, man.
Now,
put
man.
That motherfucking phone to charge, man. I seen Reggie at the store the other day, man. Reggie Williams. You know what I'm saying? That's that. But you never came back as far as like saying what's up when JT said he fried you, man. So we gonna leave that like that. You know what I'm saying? Just holler at me, though. Let me know about that one, man. So look here, man. We're going to close, man. My man JT came through, man. Watched the game with us. Mm-hmm. Laugh and joke, man. Had a good time. You know what I'm saying? Last minute situation. My dog showed up for me, man. We're going to have him back on the show another time, man. But at the same time, man, Red Cup. You know what I'm saying? So appreciate y'all's support and everything. Myself, Ricky Gorn, Charlie Moe. And all that, man. So we gonna get out of here after this one, man. But hey, we gonna keep it moving with this one, man. Every Saturday, man. Appreciate y'all, man. Y'all have a good one, man. Peace. Peace.